Ryan Burnett stops Jelmet Gamara in 6 rounds. Now, this was Ryan Burnett's comeback fight after his loss to Nonito Donaire back in November in the World Boxing Super Series. For those who don't know or didn't see that fight, Ryan Burnett suffered a back injury in the 4th round. It looked at the time to be very serious. He was stretched out of the ring. And it seemed in that fight to stem from Burnett kind of pivoting off his back foot. And I don't know, maybe there was a muscle went, or I don't particularly know. But that was what happened. So this was his comeback fight. And from the opening bell, Burnett didn't seem to have any fear of that injury reoccurring. Because there are some fighters, when they've suffered an injury, there's little telltale signs. If they've broken, we'll say, a hand, they might be a bit reluctant to throw it again straight away. Or, you know, if there's little injuries there, sometimes it's playing on a fighter's mind. Ryan Burnett was pivoting well. He was, you know, moving side to side perfectly. He's pivoting again off his back foot. So he didn't seem to have any worries about the injury. Ryan Burnett's performance in this fight was, for my money, it was very good. He wasn't in there with, you know, an elite world level fighter. Let's not say he was. But he looked good. He looked sharp. He definitely looked very, very sharp in this fight. And he was doing a great job with that slick defensive movement, which you tend to see from Adam Booth fighters nowadays. He was doing a great job with that. One kind of criticism I would have is, and I wouldn't mind, Barry Jones said it as well, it was that in the 2nd round, Gamera got Ryan Burnett up again the ropes, kind of in the corner, trapped him in the corner, and he threw loads and loads, I don't know how many punches he threw, but he threw a good few punches at Ryan Burnett. Now, they missed. Ryan Burnett made a miss, and the ones that were landing, they were landing on arms, they were hitting gloves, which is, you know, shows that he was good defensively, and shows that, you know, the movement, he's very good at evading the shots. But as Barry Jones said, if you're a judge looking at that, you're seeing one fighter throwing loads of punches, and the other guy, fair enough, he's avoiding them, but he's pinned in a corner, not going anywhere, and not doing anything. So it might be something that Ryan Burnett want to address. You see, tend to see that with Adam Booth fighters nowadays. You see it with Josh Kelly, where they just switch off and showboat, and you're just kind of left with a vision of, you know, them not doing anything, and the opponent throwing a load of punches. Which, if you're a judge, you know, maybe it might sway you, but I kind of knew there just wouldn't be relevant in this fight. Ryan Burnett done a great job of throwing lead right hands when he was on the back foot, and, you know, he was finding the home for them with ease. Another little criticism I had was when he would get Gamera hurt, he would kind of smutter his own work from time to time. At least early on, he seemed to be doing that. You know, he might buzz him, and then he'd just come in and just smutter the work and then fall into a clinch. But, you know, as the rounds went on, that kind of ceased from then on in. Gamera complained to the referee a couple of times about low blows in this fight, and some of them were low, and Ryan Burnett did get a point taken off in the 6th round for a low blow. And, you know, it was that, while some of the shots that Ryan Burnett was throwing, even he kind of admitted himself that, you know, some of them were low, but the shot that ended this fight was a body shot that landed just under the elbow, right on the rib cage. And Gamera, as soon as that landed, he didn't go down, but he turned his back, and I think he tried to, they said it on commentary as well as did Barry Jones, that maybe try and con the ref, they thinking it was a low blow. Referee knew better and immediately waved the fight off. And that was that. So Ryan Burnett's back, he got a nice stoppage. You know, he looked very, very good. Look, the movement looked good, you know, the reflex looked on point. Ryan Burnett's not a devastating puncher, but I think he's got respectable power there. I just think he's on his toes so much, and he's not leaning into the shots, he's not planting his feet, so he's probably not getting as much power as maybe he could. But they're only like minor little criticisms on this. He has now signed with Top Rank Bob Arum. He's left Eddie Hearn and Matchroom, and in the coming day, it's been announced that Naoya Inoue has now signed for Bob Arum and Top Rank as well. So that'd be a fight that a lot of people are going to be talking about and seeing what might happen. Ryan Burnett would need to not let himself get trapped in a corner against someone like Inoue, because this guy, he fought, only had something like 7 stoppages in, you know, however many fights. So he can get away with it against guys that, someone like Inoue, you do not want to be getting trapped in a corner with him, because, you know, he will do damage if you get trapped in a corner with him. So if that fight happens, you know, I would wish Ryan Burnett the best of luck in it. I wouldn't be picking him. I'd be picking Inoue. I think that Inoue, even though he's a massive puncher, he does appear to have some skill there. But who knows when that fight might happen. Again, there's also talk of Zelani Tete Zelani Tete versus Ryan Burnett. I'd like to see that fight. I think that'd be a very, very intriguing fight. But back onto this fight here. Again, good performance from Ryan Burnett. Nice to see him back. And he's at super bantamweight now, but I can imagine he'll probably drop back down to bantamweight because the fights against Tete and the fights against Inoue, they're back down at 118 pounds. So we'll see what Burnett does from here. It was a good fight. He looked well. There's not much else I can say about it. Like the video if you enjoyed it. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. And as always, I will talk to you after.